members of the fourth estate of the realm, we welcome you to the inaugural press conference of Nigeria First. I will go straight into the text of this address. We are also duty-bound to ensure that peace and tranquility reign supreme in Nigeria through the periodic engagement of stakeholders using activities that will foster peace and unity amongst Nigerians. Nigeria First sees the peace and tranquility of Nigeria as a collective endeavor that should be undertaken by all well-meaning Nigerians. As such, all acts of social, political, or economic sabotage must be resisted by all in all ramifications. This is on the heels that recent events in the country have indicated a grand plot by some despicable element to truncate and nascent democracy by the sponsorship of acts of violence in parts of the country. It remains the candid opinion of Nigeria First that the bulk of those engaged in this despicable enterprise are in the diaspora, where they have been sponsoring acts of violence against the country to fulfill the desires of their paymasters. It is quite sad that some Nigerians have elected to be blinded by feeding luxury by availing themselves as willing tools for use by those vested interests against Nigerians' peace, stability, and unity. It is also sad that some Nigerians in the diaspora constitute the bulk of these groupings that have been engaged in this despicable act aimed at undermining national security, national peace, national stability, and national unity of this country. It is expected that Nigerians in diaspora will carry themselves as worthy ambassadors of this country. However, the reverse has been the case in the light of the recent revelations in the country. It is instructive to state that some of these individuals are known faces who have been carrying out advocates of good governance, while in truth, they are promoters of violence, crime, and criminalities. These individuals have also perfected the art of using all available mediums to spew hate and innuendos that aims to cast the government of Nigeria in bad light before the populace and the international community. Without missing words, it is a considered opinion of Nigeria First that some Nigerians in diaspora have constituted themselves into greater danger to our democracy. They are the brain behind plots to overthrow a democratically elected government in Nigeria. They are also behind the escalation of fake news in Nigeria, as evident in the ENSAS protests across the country, where wide allegations were made without any tangible evidence to back them up. Nigeria First is stating in unequivocal terms that should this act be allowed to go unchecked, Nigeria might one day erupt in flames in fulfillment of the desires of those agents of darkness that are against the soul and spirit of our great country. Nigeria First is stating, consequently, Nigeria First wishes to use this medium to send a clarion call to all well-meaning Nigerians to come together and save Nigeria before the destructive elements in our midst and those in the diaspora achieve their aims. On the plot to undermine Nigerians' stability, times without number, we've received security reports alerting well-meaning Nigerians to some of these activities. And as a matter of fact, because it is our country, we must not wait for the security agencies to do everything. When a certain person called Oguche bombed Nyanya, he took the intervention of Nigerians who saw him a day or two before that day with some funny tools, to draw the attention of security agencies, even if after that had taken place. So I want to strongly believe that if those people had reported to the police a day before that day, that incident would have been averted. And that is exactly what all of us are doing today. We believe that it is the responsibility of every one of us as citizens of this great country to contribute to the peace process and, where necessary, to contribute to the stability of this great nation. or those plotting to undermine the nation, you oppress people, you must have seen activities of persons that are in this direction. Let me quickly point out two or three individuals, you know, whose activities in recent times, you know, cannot be in any way for the growth and development of this country. One of such persons is Messer Nnamdi Kanu, who ran away from this country as a fugitive. He's not the only person having a case in the court. Sabo Dasuki, a member of the People's Democratic Party, also had the same issue. These issues are running in the court, but Mr. Nnamdi Kanu has chosen to be the only one who escaped out of this country. And from wherever he is hiding, he has continued to churn out propaganda and falsehood that have really, really contributed negatively, you know, to the issue of insecurity in this country. We all saw what happened in Lagos when Mr. Nnamdi Kanu read a particular speech from the United Kingdom asking members of IPOB to go after Yoruba people and their properties in Lagos. He took the intervention and the wisdom of our brothers and sisters in Lagos to resist that temptation. What he had wanted to truncate at that time would have been a clear case of civil war where the Yorubas would be bitter and they would go after our Igbo brothers in Lagos. And all of us today know exactly what would have been the impact of that on our national life and even the cohesion of this country. And the right answer to that will be nothing but the truth. When this similar question was asked our friend with the short in Calabar, he failed to name who was supporting him or whatever, of course, because of whatever motive that was behind it. I think if our motive is for the benefit and the good of our country, and if our motives are for the good of humanity, the question of who is behind is not really the issue. But for us, we must also know that organizations, NGOs, both local and international, have all existed for one aim or the other. And that answer, the answer to your question, is best found in the aim and objective of our organization, that we are here to foster national unity, national cohesion, and national stability. And for that purpose, we will be ready to do everything humanly possible within the ambit of the law to ensure that we resist these elements that want to destroy this country. I want to add, many Nigerians who are today in the diaspora, they are not in any way better than many of us. As a matter of fact, many of them left this country because of their criminal record in the country. I've mentioned earlier, I will equally add that our friend, Mr. Showori, who uses his platform, the Sahara Reporter, of course, the organization in one way or the other has contributed to the growth and development of this country in the fight against corruption. But times with that number, we have equally seen where the platform is used to slander innocent Nigerians. And some of these persons, they have died without any justice, and that is also because of how powerful we are as the media. So, and that is why we're appealing to all of us that we all have a role to play. The revolutionary project that's been going on in the country, all of us, by now, we must have concluded within our heart of heart that it does not in any way spare good for this country. Anything that spills blood. I was talking to a group of persons when the NSAS protest was going on. Many of us initially were part of the protest at the beginning, when it was a constructive approach to stop the excesses of the Nigerian police. But the moment the revolution now entered, all of us, we know the history of revolution across Africa and the rest of the world. It has always been a violent, you know, and very acrimonious action between parties involved. I want to believe that today no one seated here is even ready to die. So why should anyone instigate anybody, you know, to stand up and begin to kill either people in government or to begin to kill us? We saw the deaths and killings during the NSAS protest. We don't want to witness that again. And that is why an organization like Nigeria First, that is ready to stand for Nigeria, an organization that is going to stand for the interests of our country, has been vetted. And we are using this medium to extend a hand of fellowship to those of them in the revolution now, and to those in the diaspora who mean well for Nigeria, and those in government, either in APC or outside PDP, that it is a time for all of us to find a common ground in addressing the issues of this country, and for us to serve as citizen soldiers to challenge and to halt any attempt to undermine the peace and stability of this great nation.